It's your drug dealer. I thought I'd call in case you needed anything at all.
It's hard being a pharmacy manager. Not only do you have to deal with the daily stress of being a pharmacist, you have to deal with customer complaints, technicians calling off, district managers yelling at you about your goals. Someone once asked me, "What happened to all your hair?" I told them I became a pharmacy manager. It's not as easy as it looks. I was a pharmacy manager for 2 years. I was a pretty good one, but it wasn't easy. It took several things. You had to exercise, meditate, a whole lot of prayer. And don't forget breakfast, because you damn sure ain't getting lunch. I used to have the perfect omelet every day. 1-to-1-to-1 ratio of spices, filled to sufficient quantity with egg whites, and stir. Though it was stressful, it was rewarding. Being a pharmacy manager is a thankless job. Most people wouldn't understand. That's why I created this film, and I can show you what it's like to be a pharmacy manager.
This is good. Call me Chef Dr. Compound, boy, I tell you. Man, CVS is buying Target? Whew. I know a whole lot of people are about to lose their lunch break. Oh, I gotta get out of here.
Hello, it's your drug dealer. I thought I'd call.
Hello? Hey, this is your neighbor. I just noticed that you were in your car warming it up, so I wanted to catch you before you head out to work.
No, I'm not actually in my car. I'm still in the house, but I have an auto remote start.
Oh, I see. You got one of them fancy cars doctors drive around in with the automatic start.
But yeah, how can I help you?
Since you were on your way to work, I was wondering if you could just refill my medications for me.
Well, which medicines do you need?
How about refill all of them?
Whatever I need.
Okay.
Man, I hate when customers say refill all my medications. I mean, like, half of them are refilled too soon, and the other half, when you fill them, when they come to pick it up, they don't even want it. I swear, every time a customer calls the pharmacy and tells me they want to refill all their medications, I'm seriously sitting there like, oh, and whatever I'm out of refills of,
can you fax my doctor for me?
And another thing, I got express pay on my account.
Can you bring out my medicines and bring them to my home tonight?
Yeah, okay. I'll bring them when I get off of work, but I gotta go.
As a pharmacy manager, I used to always make deliveries. I never really mind delivering to my patients because they needed their medication. Well, except for that one time when that lady's elevator broke.
Finally, I made it to the 50th floor.
Laura! full names, huh?
Dr. Shaw, new pharmacy manager.
How can I help you?
Brought you your medication.
Why my bag open?
Sorry, I had to use your inhaler on the 30th floor when I had an asthma attack.
Mm-hmm. Don't look too close. You know, you make good money too. I ain't ever too old for a sugar daddy.
Considering all the insulin medication in this bag,
mm-hmm.
I don't think your body needs any more sugar.
You see that 69, son? It ain't no coincidence.
Keep it.
Well, thank you, son. You know where I live.
And then there was that other time I had to make that delivery in the ghetto.
Hi, Mrs. Jenkins. This is the pharmacy manager. Hey, I know you were having difficulty finding a ride to the pharmacy, so I decided to bring you your prescription for you. Yes, yes, you know, I just want to make sure that you stay well and you get your medicine. So I'm downstairs if you could come and get your prescription. Oh, you have trouble walking? Okay. Sure, I can bring it up to you. Which house is yours? The brown one?
Better not come over here, pharmacist. We gonna rob you.
Oh, thank you. Hold up.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Won't you bring me home some gas acts too while you're at it? Okay, doc, you the man. You the man, doc. You the man. See you tonight. I love that, pharmacist. Woo, that was bad. Bring me some of that gas action.
Oh, my technician texted me. Oh, my technician called off. I had a floater working yesterday. I just know today is gonna be terrible. Man, I'm definitely going to be drinking you later today. Ugh.
As a pharmacy manager, that's one thing you hate to hear, and that's call-offs. I swear, every time my technicians call off, I'm always like,
no! No! No!
I hate working by myself. Ugh, it's the worst. I swear, working by yourself as a pharmacist is kind of like...
You're the pharmacy manager?
Yes.
Is the pharmacy open?
No, the pharmacy doesn't open for another 30 minutes.
Hey man, I gotta run to work. Do you know if I have any refills on my blood pressure medication?
Sir, does this look like the pharmacy? I don't even know who you are.
Never mind, I'll call later. Oh, wait. One last question. My doctor wrote me a prescription for 10 Viagra pills, but my insurance won't cover it. So how much would that cost?
I don't know, probably a couple $100.
Well, how much is one pill?
Probably like $45.
Damn, $45 for one pill? Good lord. How much is for like 1/4 of a pill? Or like 1/8? A quarter? Come on, work with me here.
What the hell is all this? Man, I'm about to fire somebody today. Oh, whatever. Let me just get to work.
These telephones? Ugh. Hate them. But what are you gonna do? I swear, every time the phone keeps ringing in the pharmacy, I just wanna...
Thank you for calling the pharmacy. Pharmacist speaking. How can I help you? Okay, let me check. Let me do that for you. Oh, it looks like you just got this filled 3 days ago. It's refilled too soon. I'm not going to be able to fill that. Hold on, this sounds like it's going to be a long story. Okay, go ahead. Tell me how you lost your Xanax on the bus again.
I was on the bus, and the bus caught on fire, so I jumped out the window. And when I jumped out the bus, I was like, oh man, I left my Xanax on the bus.
Anything else you'd like to add to the story before I deliberate? Not feeling it. Thank you for calling the pharmacy. Pharmacist speaking, how can I help you?
I was just wondering, how late y'all sell liquor to?
Hi, how can I help you? Okay, what's your name and date of birth? Okay, hold on, let me check. Hi, it looks like we have your prescription ready, but it's at the cash price. What type of insurance do you have? Are you sure you have Medicaid? Well, I was just wondering because you're headed to the Bahamas and you're driving a brand new Lexus, so...
Oh, the drive-thru, it drives you crazy. This isn't a fast food restaurant, this is a pharmacy. I mean, sometimes I really hate that drive-thru. Well, except for that one time Adele came through the drive-thru. Hi, how can I help you?
Hello, it's me.
It's me? I'm gonna need a name and date of birth. Oh, hey, Adele! How's it going, girl?
I was wondering if after all these years you'd like to meet.
You wanna meet? Hell yeah! You fine, girl. Come over to my pharmacy.
To go over everything.
We can go over anything you like.
They say the time's supposed to heal ya, but I ain't done much healing.
Well, you know, you haven't picked up your medicines in a while. That's probably why you're not getting any better.
Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear you, girl. Hello, somebody likes the drive-thru.
I must have called 1,000 times.
I'm sorry, we were busy. I was on hold with this doctor trying to call in this compound.
I'm sorry for breaking your heart, but it don't matter. It clearly doesn't take you.
You don't have to apologize anymore. I know that was you who called corporate. Adele wasn't the only celebrity I had in the pharmacy. I've also had...
Hello, my name is Bill Cosby. I was just wondering if I could please drop off a prescription.
I think I'm gonna have to call the doctor. Dr. Heathcliff Huxtable? Is that a real doctor?
You see, I don't think the doctor's in the office right now. He only works every 6th Thursday of the month.
Yeah, I mean, even besides that, what are you using this for? I mean, besides that, we don't have this drug.
You think you can order the Quaaludes?
No, I can't order this drug. Look. I'm not
think Walmart might have the Quaaludes.
I don't know what Walmart has.
Do you mind? Could you please?
calling the police.
Calling the police?
Hello, officer. I got Bill Cosby.
Thank you for calling the pharmacist. Pharmacist speaking, how can I help you? Hey, Mrs. Jones, how are you? Yeah, let me check on your prescription. Yeah, it looks like it's not going through your insurance. It looks like we don't have your most up-to-date insurance info. Do you still have Blue Cross Blue Shield? Okay, just calm down. I'm going to call them, and I'm going to try to get the information for you. Okay, I'll give you a call back later. Okay. Let me get the number to Blue Cross Blue Shield.
Thanks for calling the insurance company. How can I help you?
I'm trying to get some insurance information for a patient.
Okay, could I get the name and the date of birth?
Mrs. Jones? Yeah, date of birth 12/17/83.
Okay, I'm going to send the new insurance information over right now.
Okay, yeah, it's still not going through the insurance.
Oh, it's still not going through? Did you try doing the whip and nay-nay?
Do what?
The whip and nay-nay.
You sure this will get this to go through your insurance if I do the whip and nay-nay dance?
Now watch me whip,
kill it.
Now watch me nay-nay.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nay-nay.
Why me do it?
Are you doing it?
Kill it. Watch
me nay-nay. Okay. Hey guys, hey, I got this guy doing the whip and nay-nay trying to get the prescription to go through. Did it go through?
Yes, it went through. Thank you. I would have never thought I had to do the whip and nay-nay just to get a prescription to go through.
Awesome. Hey, thanks for calling.
Having a district manager sometimes is the worst. District managers are kind of like ninjas. They just pop out of nowhere, start barking out orders. I swear, having a district manager is kind of like...
Hey, wash the dishes, sweep the floor, go mop the bathroom, and walk the dog.
Kind of like being a grown man and living at home with your mama.
Hey, Dr. Shaw, how's it going?
Pretty good. Good to see you again.
Yeah, thanks. I was just stopping by to see if there's anything you needed.
Well, I could use a few extra tech hours.
More tech hours? Not a chance. But I'm glad you brought up the upcoming flu season. This year, your goal is going to be 2,000 flu shots.
2,000? We barely did 700 shots last year. How am I going to do 2,000?
Well, I suggest you get out into the community and start giving out those flu shots. I'll be back later this month to see how you're doing with your goal.
In order to meet my flu shot goal, I was going to have to do two things. One, recruit some outside help. Secondly, do something creative and in a way in which no one could know my identity.
Shot yet?
No, that's how the government implants computer chips into you.
Well, you're getting one anyway.
What?
Get him.
Batman? You're gonna give me my flu shot?
It's Dr. Batman to you. You won't even fail again.
No!
Hey, you guys, you got in your flu shots yet? Huh?
Dr. Shaw, congratulations on completing your flu shot goal so soon.
Well, I just did what you told me. Went out into the community and started giving out those flu shots.
Oh, I also have some good news for you. Since you met your flu shot goal, we're gonna increase your tech hours by 2 hours per week. And by the way, you might want to take a look at the drive-thru. They got a long line back there.
Sometimes I really hate giving flu shots. Well, except for that one time.
Hi, my name is Maurice. I'm the pharmacist. How are you?
Good, how are you?
So you're here for a flu shot?
Yes, I sure am.
Okay, let me see if I could just get this sleeve up.
doesn't look like I can raise your shirt high enough to give you the flu shot, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to give you the flu shot today.
Oh. That's fine. I'll just take my shirt off. How much longer is this going to take?
It's a lot of air bubbles, so probably like another 5-10 minutes.
Because I'm kind of getting stiff.
You know, if you're getting stiff, feel free to stand up, do some jumping jacks, anything like that, you know.
Where are you sticking that again?
Well, just so we're clear, we are talking about the needle, right?
Pharmacist! Where's the pharmacist? I need some help here.
Ooh! I hate when people bang on the counter. It irritates me. It's almost like someone's scratching the chalkboard. I swear, every time someone bangs on the counter while I'm working, I always turn around like,
I know you're not banging on my counter.
How can I help you?
Look, I am not in the mood for your tube today. I'm here to drop off a prescription and to pick up one. How long is it going to take?
20 minutes.
20 minutes? All you got to do is take the pills out the big bottle and stick them in the little bottle.
Okay. I'll get you out in 5 minutes, but please calm down before you raise both our blood pressures.
Okay, Miss Johnson, I have your insulin and your new medication.
Okay, good. Great. I need my insulin. Can I ring these items up here?
Yeah. I hate ringing up things besides prescriptions in the pharmacy. I swear, a good majority of my day is spent like... How can I help you?
Hi, can I ring these items up back here?
Do you have a prescription?
No.
Fine, I guess I could ring up your grocery items. Hand them here.
Ugh, why they always run and ring up they stuff back here? Hope these eggs break. Ringing up this soup. Look at this stuff. All this stuff is expired. Egg soup, milk, this don't even go together. It's nasty. Wine, no, she don't need to be drinking. I'm putting all this in one bag. I hope this bag breaks.
Did anybody teach you how to ring up groceries?
I'm sorry. When I went to pharmacy school, bagging groceries 101 wasn't a required course.
You shouldn't put these items in the same bag.
Well, maybe you should ring that stuff up front then. How about that?
Well, you have a good day.
I did have a good day till you brought all these groceries back here.
Look, I work the walk every day. I test my blood sugar, and I don't know why the numbers are so high. I just can't figure that out. Do you know what's going on?
I have no clue why your blood sugars can be so high. Anything else I can help you with?
Yes. Will this new medication interact with all my old medications?
To be honest, I don't even know. I just took some pills from a big bottle and stuck them in a little bottle. But I hope not. Have a good... Hold up. Tom, I know you're not eating a cinnamon roll.
Yeah. I read in a diabetics magazine that cinnamon can help lower blood sugar levels. So I figured I'll have a cinnamon roll.
Cinnamon, not cinnamon rolls, man.
Yeah.
Put that down. Spit it out. Spit it out. You know what, Tom? After everything we talked about, how carbs affect your blood sugar, I can't believe you did this to me. You know what, Tom? I don't think I could be your pharmacist anymore.
No! Give me another chance!
Tom, stop it. Please, just go. I have drive-thru. Customers and their dietary lifestyle. They tell you one thing, but they really do something else, you know? It reminds me of that one time I took that guy's blood pressure. I swear, his blood pressure was so high, when I looked at the blood pressure machine, I looked at it like...
Damn!
No, seriously, I did.
Ha ha! What's up, big homie? They let you wear a white coat, huh? Hey man, I need a real pharmacist. Would you grab one for me?
I am the pharmacist.
Word! Black folks coming up! That's what's happening, baby! Ain't slanging them drugs! and he is slinging drugs. Look here, man, I don't feel too well, so I need to check my blood pressure.
All right, sure. Have a seat for me.
Man, you know, I've been feeling kind of sluggish, a little lightheaded. You know, thought I better get it checked out, or something's wrong.
Nah, it ain't gonna work. Kind of chunky.
You got a bigger cuff, man?
Yeah, let me get my bigger cuff, sir.
You sure you know what you're doing, man? Have you done this before? Hey, man, it's too tight, dude. It's, I don't think it's gonna fit.
I don't think that's gonna work either. Well, we do got one more option. Yep, I think this'll work. Damn!
Damn, what does that mean?
It says damn.
What? Let me see that. It actually says damn.
How would you say your diet is?
My diet is actually pretty good, man.
Wait, stop. Aren't you the pharmacist? I have a question for you.
Well, I'm on lunch right now, but this is what you can do. Guess you're going to have to shake the magic eight ball.
Magic eight ball? Okay, I guess I need to do it. Am I going to have any bad side effects from this medicine? It is certain.
Man, this day will not end. I got 3 more hours and then I'm done. I just need a 15-minute break, a little bit of peace and quiet, and I can make it through the day. Yes?
Hey, pharmacist, you in there?
Yeah, I'm using the bathroom.
Oh, okay, my bad. Hey, so, is my prescription ready? They said it'll be ready in, like, 20 minutes.
How long ago did you drop it off?
5 minutes.
So why do you think it'll be ready? Customers hate waiting on their prescriptions. I mean, I remember that one time that customer had to wait.
Excuse me, is my mother's prescription ready?
No, it's not quite ready yet.
Excuse me? She's been waiting a long time. Excuse me, why isn't her prescription ready yet?
Probably the same reason why it's 1 o'clock on a Wednesday and you're not in school. I don't know.
If my mother's prescription isn't ready in 5 minutes, you will be in trouble.
It amazes me that customers yell at pharmacists. I mean, come on, it's not like you're going to Best Buy where you're yelling at somebody who knows nothing about you. I mean, pharmacists, we know what medicines you take, what pharmacies you fill at, where you live, where your family members live. I mean, what if pharmacists were crazy? It might go something like this.
I'm so tired of this, man. You don't even know what I had to deal with today. I'm so tired of these damn pharmacists. Yeah, so I had to cuss him out because I had to pay cash for my prescription because he messed up with the insurance. Wait a minute. I done forgot my prescription at the pharmacy. What are you doing here?
Left your medicine at the pharmacy.
How do you know where I live? You know what? I'm calling corporate on you.
Corporate can't help you here. Hi, how can I help you?
I need to fill this prescription.
Yeah. I don't think so. This is definitely a fake prescription. Fake prescriptions. Gotta love them. Have you ever seen a prescription so fake that you couldn't help but look at the prescription like,
oh lord, this prescription looked fake.
It's funny, every time someone brings me a fake prescription, I'm like,
for you to even ask me that, you must be stupid. Now baby, I'm not gonna be able to do.
Can you do it?
I'm not gonna be able to do.
Can you do it?
Be able to do.
Can you do it?
I'm not gonna be able to do.
So you calling me a liar?
I'm not calling you a liar.
This is a real prescription. Look at it, it's real.
I can tell by the writing that this is clearly fake.
Now you know all doctors have bad handwriting.
Yeah, it's not the handwriting that's the problem. It's the fact that it's written in red crayon. So, unless your doctor is Dr. Seuss, I'm not going to be able to fill it.
You know what? This is really poor customer service. Can I see the manager?
Oh, you want to speak to the manager?
Yeah, let me see the manager.
Okay, give me one sec. I'll go grab him.
Yeah, do that.
Hi, I'm the manager. Nope.
What's the number for corporate?
Sure, I'll get you the number to corporate. There you go.
Hello, is this corporate?
Hi, this is corporate. And no, we're not filling that fake prescription. Have a good day. Man, 10 more minutes. Whew, then I get to go home. Hope no one else comes in here.
I have a few prescriptions I need to have filled.
Are you even sick? You don't even feel hot.
What?
Sick?
What? No. Fine, I'll get. All right, ma'am, your total is $10. Just go ahead, $10, slide your card.
Don't you hate it? 10 minutes left to go on a day. You think you're about to go home. All of a sudden, a customer walks in with like 10 prescriptions. I swear, every time a customer brings me a stack of prescriptions right before we close, I'm always like,
Alright ma'am, your total is $10. Just go ahead, $10, slide your card whenever you're ready. Like that, there you go. Now put your 4-digit PIN number in.
Okay. Digits, is that like numbers or letters or
no,
could it be
no,
both?
No, it's it'll just be 4 numbers.
Bring it, I didn't bring it. I knew it this morning.
Four digits, please, anytime.
Do you have a phone I can use to call? Oh, he wouldn't be home anyway, never mind.
Yeah, wake me up when you remember those 4 digits, ma'am. It's only 11 o'clock.
Well, that wasn't it.
Oh, what a day. So glad to finally be home. Need to pour me a drink. Oh, got a text message. Oh, man, my technician called off tomorrow.
Sometimes as a pharmacy manager, the day is so busy, you actually forget about all the good that you do. Like how you caught Mr. Johnson's drug interaction, how you helped Mrs. Eggleston save money on her co-pays, how you even deliver medications to your patients. And even once in a while, you're reminded. It's not so bad being a pharmacy manager.